Good morning. As earlier mentioned by Secretary Balisakan, as of today, the total requirements estimated for the Yolanda Rehab and Reconstruction Program is 150.003 billion. This has been significantly reduced because if you recall, the typhoon hit in November 2013. At that point, the appropriation for 2013 was practically depleted already. In fact, we were able to put together about 32 billion just for the immediate response. And at that point too, the budget for 2014 had already been practically put together, so that many of the agencies who had to respond to Yolanda in about 44 provinces that were hit in varying degrees had to review their budget for 2014, and the tasks was to try to realign their budgets for different programs in those areas that were affected by Yolanda. And many of these happened without reports coming in promptly, because understandably the more difficult task was really to come up with the implementation-ready rehab and reconstruction project, which had to be preceded by assessments and on the ground. So really doing the numbers and visiting villages to find out exactly the extent to which either public or local infrastructures were damaged by the typhoon, housing requirements, as well as the extent to which livelihood was affected and the need to respond with rehabilitation projects. So after NEDA did another round of assessment, the total requirements has been pegged at 150 billion. And if you look at the slide, that is the distribution of the 150 billion pesos that we need to, as I will show later on, a significant portion of this has in fact already been released. But the biggest requirements were, of course, provided to the National Housing Authority. You know, we had to do housing in three stages. The first one is emergency shelter assistance, and then subsequently transitional housing, and then now the construction of permanent houses. So a lot of this, especially the emergency shelter assistance, was provided by the Department of Social Welfare and Development, and the transitional as well as the permanent housing was a joint effort of the DPWH and the National Housing Authority. But for the most part, especially for permanent housing, that is really now the responsibility of the NHA. But the next biggest allocation, understandably, was received by the DSWD. If you look at the table, that's 22.986 billion next to NHA's 61.261 billion. And this really covers the relief response as well as the emergency shelter housing, emergency shelter assistance provided mainly through the local government units. And of course, following that would be the Department of Education, and then the DILG, because we also came in to support the rehabilitation and reconstruction of local infrastructure, so principally, you know, municipal buildings, local markets, and prison facilities, and of that sort. So, and these were, many of these were released directly to the local government units on the assumption that they were in the position to immediately begin construction. But as you may have seen, many of the municipal buildings, especially in Leyte, were inoperable, so therefore the delay in the reconstruction. And then following that is the Department of Education, and then the Department of Agriculture, and then Philippine Coconut Authority, and then the Department of Agriculture and DPWH. So this is the amount that finally NEDA has put together. Now, if this is the total requirement, how much allotments have already been released to respond to this? It's the total so far as of October 31 is 93.87 billion. And the 93.87 billion has been sourced from different funding sources, starting with the biggest source was savings generated as a result of the inability of the agencies to implement regular programs and projects in the areas hit by Yolanda. So that's about 23.84 billion. That is followed by the use of unprogram fund, which was principally funded by excess collections from GOCC dividends. And then, of course, that was followed by supplemental budgets approved in the House of Representatives. There was one in 2014 and another one in 2015, totaling 16.33 billion. And then we also had a rehabilitation and reconstruction program in the budget, for which about a little over 10 billion was provided. And then, you know, some automatic appropriations, about 2 billion, and quick response funds of some of the agencies. So out of the 150 billion, 93.87 as of October 31, has been released. Now, where did the 93.87 billion go? Okay. There is a website where you can actually find the details of this down to the level of projects, which will show you the date of release of the allotments, the SARO number, the project, the amount, and the dates released. You can find this at yolanda.dbm.gov.ph. Is that correct? Okay. Just to show you what this site has. Okay. So this one will give you a summary of where the 93.87 go? Okay. Not the detail, just the summary. Now this is the detail. Well, okay. This is an example of what you can find in the website. So you will see. You will see there the implementing agencies, the fund source as we showed earlier, and then the allotments released to them, the dates of the release, the purpose of the release, and then the years that they were released. So this is every project funded by the 1993.87 billion releases so far. So you can just check on that and you will see all of that. Now, so what happens to the balance of 56.2 billion? Well, the 10.2 billion is already funded but has not yet been It will be released in due time, certainly within November, and it will be funded from savings of the national government. And the big source of savings is really the savings generated by the Department of Public Works and Highways, because it's been able to bid projects lower than the approved budget for contract. So they have been able to generate enough funds, not only to fund the 10.2 billion required by Yolanda in 2015, but also those required by Lando, as well as the other calamities that have hit the country. So with 10.2 billion already funded for 2015, what about the 46 billion pesos? The 46 billion pesos is already provided in the 2016 budget. The NHA's requirement of 25.6 billion is already in the budget. The requirements of the other agencies under a fund called Yolanda Rehabilitation and Reconstruction Program, which is 18.9 billion, is also in the 2016 budget. And the 1.65 billion that's required by the LUA, the Local Water Utilities Administration, and the National Electrification Administration, which support the settlements project that need the utilities, is also provided in the 2016 budget. Now, we have requested all the agencies that have allocations for Yolanda in 2016 to fully disaggregate their budgets and at the same time to begin the process of procurement so that on day one when the budget is approved, then they can publish the results of the bids and issue notices of award and subsequently the notices to proceed. And this way, the 46 billion can then fall under the GAA as release document, which means they will be automatically released to the agencies without need for them to go to DBM to request for special allotment release orders. So, in a word, we already have completed the funding the 150 billion. Funding requirements for Yolanda, 93.87 billion has already been released. 10.2 billion will be released this November, and the 46 billion is in the budget of 2016. Now, we have been repeatedly asked, so what about the donations received from international agencies? Now, I'd like to refer you to the other website, which has been there a few weeks after the Yolanda hit, in fact, a few days after Yolanda hit. And if I can refer you to Faith, there you go. You know, we received 73.3 billion pesos by way of pledges from international agencies, both bilateral as well as multilateral. And as of November, this year, that is broken down into 45.1 billion in cash and 28.2 billion in cash. If you go to FAITH, the website, you will see who committed what and in what form, you know, just to be fair. Now, to this day, we have the amount of cash and non-cash pledges that have been realized, total 17.23 billion pesos, or about 23.3%. Now, saan nagpunta yung 17.23 billion pesos? The bulk of this actually went to the international agencies, local affiliates or their like UN agencies in the country, and about 14.8 billion of that, or 20%, went to them. You know, how much went to government? Well, in cash, the government received 1.2 billion pesos. In non-cash, these are, you know, hospital beds and medicines and blankets. 1.2 billion pesos, or about 3.3% of you know, what was pledged to us. So we can only account for the 2.4 billion pesos. If you want an accounting of the 14.8 billion pesos, then you will have to check with the agencies, the international affiliates who are based here, who received them. And if you want to ask what is going to happen to the 76.7% that has not yet been remitted to us, well, you will see in the website those agencies that still need to make those remittance. And it's better for you to check with them because they're in a better position to answer. So that's the situation insofar as funding the Yolanda requirements in this country is concerned. Thank you very much.